And the answer for the new mean is 70,000. Obviously, everyone's salary increased. And the new sigma stays the same. We already talked about this example earlier in class, but now it's in the context of a normal distribution. So let me take a second to show this to you. In our normal, ignoring the normalization constant, we know that everyone's salary is drawn from a distribution that looks like this. This is plugging in the mean and the variance as I defined it. And now we know we set the new salary x prime to be the old salary plus 10,000. That is the same as saying that the old salary is the new salary minus 10,000. If we now substitute this x over here with this expression over here, what we get is something that looks as follows. So you can see I took out the x and replaced it by x prime minus 10,000. And if you look at this carefully, you'll find this is the same as x prime minus 70,000, the square, or 10,000 square. So I proved to you that the variance or the standard deviation doesn't change, and the mean is affected by just increasing it to 70,000. Put differently, mu prime is now 70,000, and sigma prime remains 10,000.